Tom Becker says, some of the stuff in the cheat sheet is really great, especially stuff about saponification of minerals. I would love to share this with my oxalate friends. I keep telling Ben Lynch that folks with high fat and diet or poor fat breakdown, PEMT, are going to be a sitting duck for oxalate issues. The high fecal fat seems to be a big deal in that this fat is going to create soap with calcium and prevent calcium from binding with oxalate to assist in excretion. Do you agree? Tom, I do agree with your last statement. So let me go through one by one. First of all, saponification of minerals, the point here is that if you have malabsorption of fat, the fatty acids are going to bind to any positively charged minerals in your diet. And this has been particularly well studied in preterm infants, where if the poor digestion of fat or poor absorption of fatty acids causes the fatty acids to bind to the calcium and have lower bioavailability. So if you surpass your ability to absorb the fat, the fatty acids can bind minerals and induce mineral deficiencies. I agree with this. I don't agree that PEMT polymorphism is a marker of poor fat breakdown. PEMT polymorphism is a marker of poor synthesis of phosphatidylcholine that will impair export of fat from the liver, but that I don't know. Maybe what you're saying is that poor phosphatidylcholine production in the liver would lead to poor bile acid emulsification in the gallbladder, which would lead to, okay. Yeah. I see your line of reasoning. Okay. I take back what I said. Okay. So yeah, low phosphatidylcholine synthesis due to the PEMT. I was thinking of it as a direct marker, and it's not a direct marker, but it could theoretically impact. And this is probably especially true if you have a low phosphatidylcholine intake. Probably eating phosphatidylcholine protects against this, but yeah, low phosphatidylcholine levels in the liver, partly as an interaction between low activity of the PEMT enzyme and low intake of phosphatidylcholine from food, could cause bile acid issues, which could in turn cause fat malabsorption. Okay, yes, I agree with that. Then the high, then I agree with everything you said. If you have fat malabsorption and you have enough digestion of the fat to release the free fatty acids from triglycerides, but you don't have enough absorption of those fatty acids will bind calcium. And they won't bind oxalate, they can't. And so binding the calcium will lower the calcium absorption, and it will also prevent the calcium from binding oxalate. Calcium binding oxalate is what prevents oxalate absorption. So yes, I would think that would increase oxalate absorption. Absolutely. Thank you, Todd, for your question.